Myself Ankita Tiwari from LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. I am going to take the topic that is flip-flops from the subject that is digital fundamentals. In that, we are taking this topic from the module 3, that is sequential circuits. So basically, we will be starting with the topic flip-flops from module 3. To study, first of all, what are flip-flops? So flip-flops are application of logic gates. Application of logic gates means logic gates we have already studied. The types of gates, that is AND, OR, NOT, XOR, XNOR. Okay, so using that gates, we are going to study the flip-flops. So in the flip-flops are constructed from the gates itself. Now, which of the gates we can use in flip-flops? So it depends on the application or the type of flip-flop that we are using it. Basically, we can say that flip-flop is a memory element. Now, what do you mean by memory element? As we know that we are having RAM and ROM as memory element. Okay, that means you can store something. Now here, if I'm talking about flip-flop and if I'm talking about storing, so that includes binary form only. That binary includes only two values, that is 0 and 1. So we can say that RAM is a memory element. So here flip-flop is also a memory element which stores information in the form of 0 and in the form of 1. Only that much value can only be saved in flip-flop. Moving forward, in flip-flop, we know that flip-flop stores information. But why only flip-flop we will use? So in flip-flop, we are having a very good concept of feedback circuit. And what do you mean by feedback? Feedback means, suppose we are having two states, the next state and the state at which we are at. Okay, so considering the previous state value and to find out the next state value, for that previous value is required and it should be given to the current situation and then the next output will be derived. So for that, the flip-flop is being used. So we can say that flip-flop is having a feature of providing feedback. To derive a new one, we can use the previous state. So here, flip-flops are also of four types. So basically, flip-flops are of four types. Here we can see that SR flip-flop, then we are having D flip-flop, then we are having T flip-flop, and we are having JK flip-flop. So basically, we will be studying in this topic four types of flip-flop. That four types includes SR, JK, T and D. Okay. Moving forward, here we can say that in flip-flop, it stores memory. But how much bit it stores? Only one bit. That is either 0 or either 1. So we can say flip-flop is a one single bit memory element. It stores only one bit and it gives also one bit. Now if we want to store bit a value of 4 bit. So we require 4 flip-flop continuous sequentially in the same line connected together and then we can store it. So that concept we will be studying after studying the types of flip-flop. So we will be starting with the first type of flip-flop, that is SR flip-flop. Okay, so SR flip-flop, here from the word itself we can get that SR, S set, R reset. Okay. So R and S, these two values itself gives the values of, that is set and reset. Set means setting the value. Here it is Boolean value, that is 0 or 1. So setting the value means it will set to 1 and reset the value means it will reset to 0. So for that, to understand any flip-flop, we will be using the gates because flip-flop comprises of gates. So the flip-flops are made of with the help of two gates, that is NOR gates and NAND gates. So how many gates are required for designing a flip-flop? So two NOR gates and or two NAND gates. So it is a or means we can derive from any of the gates. Okay, so here I will be explaining you both the circuits, that is using NAND and using NOR. But how many gates are required? That is two. Okay. So we will be doing the first topic, that is SR flip-flop using NOR gates. Okay. So here the circuit comprises of NOR gate concept. Here, clock is not provided in the circuit. So it is basically called as latch. So here, this circuit is also known as a SR latch. Okay. So you can see the circuit from the figure itself. Here, we have to assume that this circuit will work with respect to some clock only. That clock will be positive or negative, but here it is not applied. Everything into the system is being working with the clock pulse only. So here only we are seeing the circuit, not with respect to clock. So we have to assume it that clock signal will be provided with positive signal and negative signal, and with respect to that we will get the output. Okay. Here, as you can see, R value and S value. If you are taking an R, that is reset, so that will be comprises with Q, okay? Because S and R are complementary of each other. So its output will also complement its value each other. So here R value is having Q as an output and S value is having Q bar as an output. Because from the word itself, S stands for set, R stands for reset. So for S, it is Q dash, and for R, it is Q. So that thing you have to keep in mind. Here the output bit complement, it should compulsory complement each other. Now the circuit is designed, we know that flip-flop provides feedback circuit. Means feedback means it's a loop. So here R is being connected with previous output as Q dash of S itself. The same thing, S will be connected with the previous output of R, because set and reset value works together. Okay. So this is the predefined circuit of flip-flop that we have to digest and we have to work on it itself. We have to understand this circuit actually. Okay. Now, in order to understand the working of this circuit, we will take the truth table, means the values itself. We are having two inputs, that is S and R. So possible combinations are four, but that doesn't mean in four compulsory the value will not be repeated. No. Depending on the condition, the value can be repeated with respect to S and R value. So here, S, R, two variables, two inputs given as in flip-flop. Its value will be, but of course, 4, that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So we'll take one by one with an example and we'll understand how this circuit works. So as you can see here, first value, that here it is being defined as 1, 0. Now, what is the concept of NOR? NOR means, we have to just understand the concept. We will take the concept and we will have the example and we will understand it, how it works. So, in NOR, if any of the input is 1, its output will be 0. This is the concept of NOR. Okay, that we have to keep in mind. If any of the input is 1, output is 0. If both the inputs, compulsory condition, if both the inputs are 0, then and only the output will be 1. So here we will not going for 0. We will just understand the concept that if any of the input is 1, output is 0. Okay. So here S and R, in this first value, S value is 1. So here 1 is applied. 1 is applied. So we will get Q bar as 0. See, 1 is applied, we will get Q bar as 0, and Q is complement of Q bar, so we'll get Q as 1. So we got Q as our output as 1 when condition 1 0 was applied into the flip-flop. The second condition, that is 0 0. Here 0 0 value, if it is applied, means set value is also 0, R value is also 0. We cannot predict the answer because one input is 0. That means we have other conditions as well to find out if both the inputs are 0, then and only then the output will be 1. So for 0 the condition, we have to find out the other input as well. So here previous state value is required. Without having the previous input, we cannot predict the next output. Okay, so for that, we will assume or we will take value as, that is 0, 1, okay, that is 0, 0. So we will assume, that is, we have to take two conditions for it, whether the previous state would be 0 or it would be 1. Means two conditions we have to take in mind and we have to solve it. So here 0, 0 input, at 0, 0 previous state, suppose it is 0, we'll take this, and if it is 0, 0 previous state it is 1. So here 2 times 0, 0 is been repeated, that you have to keep in mind why I am repeating these two. Why we are doing it? Because at 0, 0 we have to take consideration of previous state, because we cannot predict the answer on one value as 0. We have to find out the other value itself, because it can be 0 or it can be 1. If the other input is 0, then and only then output will be 1. If it is 1, output will be 0. So for that we have to keep, or we have to take two values, that is 0, 0 and 0, 0. For 0, 0, if the previous value is 0, if the value is 0, we will take as here Q bar as 0, R is 0. So 0, 0, Q will be 1. So here see, we got 1. Same, we are repeating for 0, 0. For 0, 0, Q bar is 1. Q bar is 1. R is 0. That means Q will be 0. So here we got as 0. Okay. Now, the only two conditions left, that is 0, 1 and 1. So 0, 1. See, 0, 1 means R value is 1. This will be 0. So see, R value is 1, Q value is 0. Automatic. We don't have to predict anything in this. And now the condition is 1, 1. If I am putting both the value as 1, just think about it. If I am putting both the value as 1, Q and Q bar, both will not complement each other. Why? If I am putting 1 here, 1 here, both outputs should be 0. But that is not possible, because it should complement each other. So this condition becomes indeterminate in SR flip-flop. Okay. So if it becomes indeterminate and we have to predict it, so that is not possible in SR. So here 1-1 condition will not be applicable for SR flip-flop. Okay. Moving forward, we are going for SR flip-flop using NAND gate. Same, only concept changed with gate. Okay. Here I am talking about the NAND gate. It will be opposite of NOR, but of course, so condition will be changed. If any of the input is 0, if any of the input is 0, output will be 1. It will not be 0, it will be 1. This is the concept of NAND. Okay, the same thing I have applied. SR, S is here 1. Okay, output will be 1. If any of the input is 1, output will be 1. As it is. Okay, that means if I am taking about, that is S, and I am taking about R. Okay. If we are taking that value in consideration, okay, for NAND, you have to just keep in mind, if any of the input is 0, okay, output will be 1. You have to take this into consideration. See, the 1, 0, R is 0, R is 0. Here, output will be 1, but this is complement, so it will be 0. So it will be called 0, 1. Once more, another condition we will take for 0, 1. 1, 1 we will take at last. Okay. 0, 1. So for 0, 1, R value is 1. So here R value is 1. Okay. So for that, it is not condition which is not given here. So S value is 0. So S value is 0 and Q value we will get as 1. Because if any of the input is 0, output will be 1. So we got directly here also. If I am taking about 0, 0, see, now 0, 0, if both the input is 0, output, both output will be not predictable. Okay. So for that, if both input are 0, 0, the output will be 1, 1. It is not possible because it should complement with each other. So here the indeterminate state condition is 0, 0, not 1, 1, because it will be opposite of NOR. In NOR it was 0, 0. So in NAND it will be of 0, it was of 1, 1. So in NAND it will be of 0, 0. It would be opposite. So the last condition which is left is 1, 1. Now 1, 1, the same condition as NOR gate. In NOR, if it was 0, 0, the answer was not predictable, because for condition zero it is defined, for one it is not defined. So for one, other input should be retried. So here if it is 1 1, we have to predict the previous state. So here if I am taking as 1, okay, means Q bar is 1, S is 1, so 1 1 output is 0. So we got output as 0. If I am taking 1 1 and Q as 1, so Q as 1, this is 1, so we'll get this as 0. So this is 1, so here we got Q as 1. Okay, so basically comparison with NAND and NOR, if I am taking the consideration, then we have to know just the two values, the two things, that in NOR, if any of the input is 1, output is 0. Opposite condition in NAND, if any of the input is 0, output is 1. Keeping that in mind, taking all the consideration 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, and we will get the answers. So in SR, when to take the previous? At 0, 0 value. And in NAND, using NAND in SR, when to take the previous? That is at 1, 1. Okay. So indeterminate condition in NOR was 1, 1. Indeterminate condition in SR in NAND is 0, 0. So that you have to keep in mind and you have to design the other circuits. Moving forward, in SR, we will be having clocked SR flip flop. So the same thing, nothing in extra things we are doing it. Here the clock pulse extra is being applied to the circuit with S and R. If I am applying an extra input, that is as a clock pulse, then we have to take the both input, that is clock, in both the input, that is S and R. So putting that, we have to take two AND gates as more, other than NAND and NOR gates. So here, other than this latch circuit, we will be having two AND gates, okay, to apply the clock into the circuit. So here the clock will be applied to the both, so that is input R and S, and this will be as it is that we have studied in NOR. Okay, so in NOR, only the condition that we have to understand here is indeterminate state. So here you have to understand if it is 1, 1. Just see, here the bifurcation is done at 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1. Repeating 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. Because there it was latched, clock is not provided. So here we are taking previous state as Q and next state as Q T plus 1. So previous state with 4 input as 0, 0, 0. Previous state with 4 input as 1, 1, 1, and the bifurcation is done. Same output, same input, nothing is changed. Only Q with respect to two values is changed. Nothing else. Okay. Here 1, 1. Okay. Means both the input are 1. Unpredictable answer. So here the word will be defined as indeterminate. The same thing here. 1, 1, indeterminate state. Okay. So this is what clocked SR flip flop, which is very important. Okay, based on this, the other flip-flops are being derived. Thank you.